Hey YouTube, Dustin back here again with F1 Manager 22, Haas Career Season Number 2. We're going to head to Mexico for practice and qualifying. Before I do, go ahead and smash that like button. Subscribe to the channel. Click that bell for notification. Get notified every time I upload a video. Comment on the videos. Share the videos. We got light rain for the race in Mexico. They say it's going to be nice weather for Friday and Saturday. Car analysis, we still have the best car. We're not the fastest, but our cornering speed is the best by a long shot. Red Bull's kind of screwing Max over with his cornering speed. They're giving Perez the cornering speed. If Perez is the next best driver in high-speed cornering, and he is that far back, yeah, we have a huge advantage. And Mercedes is the best at medium speed. And we are quite a bit better than them at that. And Aston Martin is the best at low speed, and we are a lot better than them. Four more weeks and he will be gone. And we will be bringing in, where's he at? Oliver Bearman. He has four more weeks also. And we will be bringing in it was him. Mario Garzulo. The two that I want though would be Jean Piero and Hugh Bird. Those would be the two that I would like to have. Still negative outlook toward my team. I don't understand it. I truly don't understand it. I'd really like to get Diego Tondi, especially with his contract ending coming up. Melvin has one more year remaining. I'd rather break the contract and get Tondi, because his performance ratings are unreal. Enrico Balboa is good. He's really good too. But Tony, everything is over 90. Everything is over 90. And there's no point in me changing out my technical chief, because Pierre and Enrico are just a little bit better than him. Personally, I think Simone is better than Enrico, because the way I've got his front wing, rear wing, and underfloor, 82, 81, 85, 83, 86, 86. So yeah, personally I think Resta is better than Cardeal. But yeah, Pierre is, yeah, he is a little bit better. It's close. But the, with how much he has on the chassis, side pods, and suspension, that's what makes him really just that tad bit better. His contract is ending also. Damn. I've got 2 years with Resta, so. We have $20 million remaining in our cost cap. And the only thing we are doing is research now, so. I will need to research another front wing. I thought about researching the suspension, but I'm tempted to just not even worry about it and just research another front wing and rear wing. Just a few more races left. Hopefully when the new F1 Manager 23 comes out, they have the, oh, what is it? The sprint races. Mick and Kevin will both receive a development point after this race. Resta will get one at the end of the week, or at the end of next week. Now let's go ahead and head on out.
Music is in the air this weekend.
Yeah, whatever. 36 laps, 35 laps. kilograms of fuel per lap. I cannot remember which way I need to go with this. Where's that 13 and 6.5? And both drivers are out for the first practice run. Yeah, so if anyone is listening to this and they... If anyone is watching the video...
And it's a crash, game, and it's crash more than one car. Let's have a look. Now look at this.
No,
it was the AlphaTauri driver involved. You can clearly
that
see
Alpha
the contact there,
out.
And that caused a lot of damage.
And that's Pierre Gasly. And we have Perez, Albon, Leclerc, Verstappen, all taking a penalty. Whoever is watching this video, if you play this game and you're starting a career, focus all your attention on the front wing, rear wing, and underfloor. Design the hell out of those as many as you possibly can during the first two seasons, and in the facilities, upgrade the wind tunnel, the CFD simulator, and the design center. Those are the three ones you want to upgrade as much as you possibly can also. And you will lead your drivers to a championship.
How's the balance?
It was okay.
Okay, understood.
All right, we'll try that for a minute. Oh, the other thing about playing this game, when your drivers get development points, focus on improving.
Here's the replay. Cornering. Right, watch this. There's Schumacher.
Braking.
That looked like a very nasty spin. That's going to be a big blow to the team. Will they be able to recover? We'll see.
Improve control and reactions and accuracy. Tire wear is a big one, but them being able to make the corners and not lock up and all that, that's why cornering and braking is so important. I'm pretty sure both drivers should be about 95% or higher. 97 for Kevin. Well, the hell with it. I'm gonna try that. Yeah, we'll give that a shot. And this will probably be the only practice that I do with Mexico because we're so close after the first practice here, so.
We'll be kicking off.
Yeah, why not? We're going to go ahead and get a new engine, ERS, and gearbox for both drivers. Where's the room? Take the full penalty. See, that was $6 million more, so we're down to about $14 million. And then it costs cap. We're not even going to run a qualifying lap. So we will start last. So found out that if you don't qualify when you take a grid penalty, and so you have both drivers finish inside the top five, with that sponsor payout, it pays out. It actually pays out for you starting 19th and 20th instead of taking the penalty and starting 19th and 20th.
Up on the track.
So we will start last, which is fine. I'm guessing we'll have to run down George Russell and Lewis Hamilton. That's who we will have to chase down. See how Perez, Leclerc, Verstappen, they're all taking a penalty.
The time has come for these drivers to fight it out wheel to wheel. Race day has arrived.
Haas gave a solid performance in qualifying, and they'll be happy enough with their grid position here. Let's see if they can make it work for them. It was a pleasure to watch Red Bull's excellent performance during qualifying. Their drivers will now be looking ahead to the race itself and hoping to capitalize. And the clouds today look very ominous, which means that teams may have to contend with rain at some point during the race.
And there are sure to be some dizzying strategies used here today, here in the Mexican Heights. The question is, though, who's going to be the one to climb to the top?
Not starting. How are we not starting last? Kevin will go on and win this race. Mick will finish. We'll say fifth. How are we not starting last? We qualified last. We took all the good penalties, but we're not starting last. How is that possible? Kevin, just to cover our ass a little bit. Kevin to finish second, Mick to finish fourth. And the rain is going to come for the end of the race, so yeah, we have four sets of fresh tires, fresh soft tires. And yes, we're going to go soft, soft. Yeah, this is about lap 41, the rain will be here. Hmm. And that will do it for practice and qualifying from Mexico for the Mexican Grand Prix. When I come back, it will be race day. When this race is over, we will have two races remaining. Sao Paulo, Brazil, and Yas Marina, Abu Dhabi. Thank y'all for watching. Let me know whether y'all want me to, I need y'all to let me know whether y'all want me to do a third season with Haas, start a new career, and which team you want, or see me doing a whole nother game. But again, thank y'all for watching. Smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and click that bell for notifications, get notified every time I upload a video. Comment on the videos, share the video. Again, when we come back, it'll be race day for the Mexican Grand Prix. And this is going to be an exciting one because it's going to be a dry to wet race. With the finish being under, in the rain, wet, wet track. So, hope everyone has a great day. I'll see you soon.